Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to study bridge course day 37th exercise. In this exercise the topic is ratio and proportion and subtopic is proportion and continue proportion. Last year we learned about ratio and proportion. Important points of this exercise is first proportion. If A upon B is equal to C upon D, then A, B, C, D are said to be in proportion. Means this ratio, if A upon B is equal to C upon D, these two ratios are equal, then A, B, C, D are in proportion. If A upon B is equal to C upon D is equivalent to A into D is equal to B into C. Means here cross multiplication is there. A into D is equal to B into C is nothing but A upon B is equal to C upon D. Both are equivalent. Now we will see the continue proportion. When two ratios are equal, like A upon B is equal to B upon C, then we can say that A, B, C are in continue proportion. Here in continue proportion, denominator of a first ratio is nothing but the numerator of the another ratio. If both are equal, then A, B, C are in continue proportion. That is, if B square is equal to AC, then A, B, C are in continue proportion. If we do the cross multiplication, B into B, B square is equal to AC, means if B square is equal to AC, then A, B, C are in continue proportion. When ABC are in continue proportion, then B is known as geometric mean of A and C or mean proportional of A and C. Means B is a geometric mean of A and C or mean proportional of A and C if ABC are in continue proportion. Let's see the exercise. In this exercise, first sum is if A, B, C, D are in proportion and A is equal to 4, B is equal to 8, C is equal to 5, then find the value of D. Here A, B, C, D are in proportion given and the value of A, B and C is given. Therefore, first write down given things. Then A upon B is equal to C upon D, then put the values. Let the value of D be a x. Therefore, first write down given things. A, B, C, D are in proportion and A is equal to 4, B is equal to 8 and C is equal to 5. Therefore, A upon B is equal to C upon D. That is, A into D is equal to B into C. Here, substitute the value of A, B and C. We get, therefore, 4 into D is equal to 8 into 5. Now here you can transfer, this 4 is multiplied, will become divide. Therefore, D is equal to 8 into 5 divided by 4. Simplifier, 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8, 5 twos are 10. Therefore, D is equal to 10. Therefore, the value of D is 10 is the answer. Second question of this exercise is, if A is equal to 2, B is equal to 3, C is equal to 4, D is equal to 6, then verify A, B, C, D are in proportion or not. In this sum, the value of A, B, C, D are given. Then verify A, B, C, D are in proportion or not. How to find? First write down the given things, then find the ratio of A to B and C to D. If these two ratios are same, then A, B, C, D are in proportion. If ratios are not same, then they are not in proportion. First, A is equal to 2, B is equal to 3, C is equal to 4, D is equal to 6. Means write down here given things. Now we will find the ratio of A to B. Therefore, A upon B is equal to 2 upon 3. Because the value of A is 2, B is 3. Here, if simplification is possible, then simplify, otherwise keep as it is. This is the equation first. And C upon D is equal to 4 upon 6. Value of C is 4, D is 6. Then simplify, 2 2s are 4, 2 3s are 6. Is equal to 2 upon 3. this is equation 2. Here observe the equation first and second. Here first is 2 upon 3, second is also 2 upon 3. Means RHS of the both equation is same. Therefore LHS is also same. Therefore A upon B is equal to C upon D. Here reason is from equation first and second. From equation first and second. Write down there. Therefore answer is yes, A, B, C, D are in proportion. Third example of this exercise is, if M is a geometric mean of 12 and 3, then find the value of M. Here M is a geometric mean of 12 and 3. Means the product of these two is nothing but square of M. If you simplify this, then you will get the value of M. First write down given things. M is a geometric mean of 12 and 3. Therefore, M square is equal to A into C. We know that the formula. Here, value of A is 12 and value of C is 3. Substitute your values. Therefore, M square is equal to 12 into 3. Here multiply this, 12 3s are 36, therefore M square is equal to 36. Taking square root of both sides, therefore M is equal to 6. Here write down reason, taking square root of both sides. Write down there, taking square root of both sides. Therefore, what is the value of M? Yes, value of M is 6. Therefore, answer is, the value of M is a 6.